Hi! In this video, I'm gonna show you how to set up a custom message after the student or your login user has marked the lesson complete. So, if on the some of the videos previously, when I marked this complete, you saw that there's a custom message that says completed, and there's also an option to report if they have issue. But other than report functionality, you can also change this to maybe if you want to receive a feedback from them regarding how this lesson went through or what they think about the instructor, etc. Those kinds of useful information that will help you improve more your lessons in the future, you can take advantage of this kind of format. So, let's check out how we set that up. If we're gonna open this lesson that we haven't marked completed yet, as you can see, it says mark complete. That means we haven't completed this yet. On the Elementor, if I hover over the editor, which I'm gonna zoom in, if I hover over here, I have a pop-up that's named lesson complete. I'm gonna open that, and then I think it's that one. And then the report form, it is also related to the jet form. The report form is also in here. Again, that's another pop-up. And we trigger both of this pop-up, whether the report form or the congratulation message. We trigger that using on-scroll element when the class name is present. So I'm going to show you what I mean. So this is the pop-up from Elementor. And you just set your design. So I'm going to close this. So you create your design. And this one is, this part here is linked to that pop-up report form. So when they click that, that pop-up will open. But for this one, this is manually entered link pointed to the archive page. And the way the settings look here is everything here is blank. The trigger came from here. So trigger, it says on scroll to element, and then the selector is this one. This class name or selector name is present on the complete button after they mark it complete. So if I edit the single post of this lesson, you will see that the button, so I'm going to open here. So complete button indicator, which is the green one, the one that they will finally see after they mark it complete. This one, if we go to the advanced settings, I'm going to zoom in. You can see that I added that lesson complete name in there without the dot. I don't need to put the dot in here. But in here, I need to have that dot on the beginning. So what's happening is after I mark this complete, then it changed, right? It reloads, and then the class name is now present, which is the lesson complete, and that's why this pop-up shows up. So I hope this video helps, and I'll see you on the next one.